It is time for another run of Lyric Theater at the Civic Center. Dave Morris here at the Oklahoma's Video Studios, talking to the man with very good posture, artistic director for Lincoln for Lyric Theater, Mr. Michael Barron.
Hey, how are you?
I'm doing well. It's great to catch up again. Thank you very much for stopping by our studio.
My pleasure. They're so fancy.
It's getting there. It has some potential. And I think when we have the streetscape out there finished, all of your adoring fans are going to be right outside the window going, Michael, Michael.
Like the Today Show.
It could be exactly like
that. But in
Oklahoma
City.
In Oklahoma City.
And I like that all the purple matches our logo. That was kind of you.
You got it. Anytime. Anything we can do to help out.
Hey.
In fact, we can set up your summer season, which leads off with Oklahoma, right?
It does. We are doing the official state production of Oklahoma. I'm excited because I'll be directing it. And we have two choreographers this year. Joe Rowan from OCU is going to direct just the ballet. It's going to be exciting to have her back. She hasn't been back to Lyric in many years.
That's great.
But she was once a performer and a choreographer for Lyric. And to have her back is just a really huge treat.
Well, you're developing a cast of all-stars for this.
Right? And then Brian Markham, who is her cohort over at Oklahoma City University in the dance program, he's coming to do all the rest of the dances for Kansas City, Oklahoma, Farmer and the Cowman. So that's quite special. And then anyone who saw the 2007 Centennial production, we're actually bringing back that physical production. So it's large, the barn is huge. We built that for that centennial, and to be able to bring it out one more time on and to do Oklahoma on that scale is going to be really exciting.
It'll be at the Civic Center Music Hall June 23rd through the 27th. You can go online, lyrictheaterokc.com, for some information on that. Moving on, Mary Poppins is after that.
Mary Poppins is in our continuing tribute and love for all things that are kids in the summer. We're doing Mary Poppins. Last year we had a huge success with Little Mermaid. And so to bring back another Disney title is exciting. It's already selling like crazy, so if you don't have your tickets, you should get it quickly. But Lindsay Van Winkle is playing Mary Poppins. She is from Oklahoma. She's born and bred here. She's in New York now doing all kinds of exciting stuff, but I'm
That's
excited
great.
To bring her back to do Mary Poppins.
There's no shortage of talent in Oklahoma.
No, and the two kids, Mary and Michael, are both right here from Oklahoma City.
Mary Poppins is July 7th through the 11th, also at Civic Center Music Hall, and then we move on to a new Broadway musical, Big Fish.
We do. I saw it at the pre-Broadway run last year in Chicago and fell in love with the material. It went to Broadway last fall. It had a short-lived run for many reasons. One, I thought, was the physical production was not up to what I like. And at Lyric, what we're going to do is build brand new sets and costumes and tell the story in a new way.
Cracking the whip on
those. Really, because I think those that saw it really loved it, but it's a Southern Gothic tale, and there was a little too much New York in the telling of it, so I'm going to take that out and bring it back to Alabama, where the show takes place. If you saw the movie that Tim Burton did, it's based on that movie and the novel, but it's a lovely story about a father and a son, and the tales the dad ends up telling about witches and giants, and what was the truth in his life and what wasn't. And we're bringing back Tony nominee Emily Skinner. She's playing Sandra. David Elder is playing the lead of Edward Bloom. And Alicia Gamble, who was in our production of Oliver, playing Nancy, she's coming back to play the witch.
We're talking with Michael Barron, artistic director at Lyric Theater. How often do you say, it's got too much New York, I want to put my stamp on? How often do you kind of mix up the ingredients on these plays?
Well, usually, with anything I do, I always like to see the original production or any revival that's done after that. I usually love them and respect them, but as a director, I want to put my own spin on it. I want to make the show relevant to our audiences today, which is even when one year takes place, the world is a different place. And then there are those troubled shows, and I think Big Fish was one of those troubled shows that people on Broadway went, oh, I wish that was a little better. But there's something there that is true and lovely. And even in the troubled version, I end up crying at the end. I thought it was just really heartfelt, but I knew physically and the storytelling could be done in a new, fresh way. So we're going to take it on.
The troubled version.
I think no one in that production would deny it was troubled.
Okay.
But it's being done all over the country, and so much so that the composer he wrote a version for just 11 people because he wanted to give smaller companies a chance to try it. But we're definitely doing the big cast version with beautiful new sets by Adam Koch, who does a lot of our sets.
Big cast, Big Fish, July 21st through the 25th. And then we wrap it up with some Elton John music, Billy Elliot in August.
Yeah, Billy Elliot. It's for those of you who hadn't seen it, it won the Tony Award. It won Best Musical in the West End. It is spectacular and definitely will be a huge challenge for Lyric in all the best ways. We did just cast our Billy. His name is Maximilian. He's a 12-year-old and a member already of the American Ballet Theater in New York.
Oh, wow.
We're bringing him in to play Billy. And the kid playing Michael, who's his friend, is coming in from Denver. He's a 13-year-old that just did it in North Carolina. But the cast is spectacular. The dance teacher, Mrs. Wilkinson, is being played by Lynn Kramer, who actually is a dance teacher. She choreographs many of our shows and directs, and she's a professor at OU. So to have her actually playing the dance teacher is going to be really exciting. But the show is, for those that haven't seen it, it's just a really powerful, the music's great, it has a rock-based score, and it deals with a difficult time in England as far as miner strikes and a lot of union strife. And here's this one kid who kind of bucks the system and says, you know, I don't really want to be a boxer. I want to be a dancer, and how the town kind of deals with that. And he succeeds. And it's a pretty glorious evening. And even though there are kids in the show, it is not for small children, I want to be clear about. I would say, you know, teens and above, because there is some language, because it does deal with adult themes, but it's a spectacular evening of theater.
That's Billy Elliot, August 4th through the 8th. Now, last October, I saw Inspector Calls, I believe, Lyric at the Plaza. It was fantastic, great storytelling. It was just a wonderfully well-done thing. But this October, you have something else coming up.
We
something
do. Brand new. We are committed now to do new works and world premieres, because I feel that, you know, for 52 years, Lyric has been doing musicals that started somewhere else. And I think it's time that those places do musicals that started right here in Oklahoma. So last year, we started that with a musical called Triangle that's already had a great success. It's playing this summer in California at Theater Works in Palo Alto. And our show this October is called Bernice Bobs Her Hair. It's based on the F. Scott Fitzgerald short story. It's an awesome turn-of-the-century musical. It's the original Mean Girls story. And it has a cast of 11 college kids and two adults, college-age kids. They're actually, some of them are older. But it's a really, really fun show, period piece, that's written by Adam Guan and Julia Jordan. And Adam, who is the hot new composer in New York, he just won the Richard Rodgers Award for Best New Composer. So to have him here in residence with Julia is going to be fantastic. And
how did you pick this show?
I saw every year I go to the National Alliance for Musical Theater Festival of New Musicals, and I saw this one there, and it was perfect. I thought we could cast it well with the local talent we have at universities, because we have such strong university programs. So I just approached the writers and said, hey, I would love to do it. Would you consider doing the first production in Oklahoma? And because of the success of Triangle, they agreed. This is a great place to try out material. We'll be able to work on it for a long rehearsal period, write new music, cut certain scenes, all away from the critical eye of New York before it gets to a major market where it will be reviewed and the world will decide whether or not it's a show that people want to see more and more. But Oklahoma is a perfect trying ground because the talent's here, the support is here from Lyric, the audiences love seeing new shows, and so they have a great experience, and it's a wonderful creative environment outside New York for these new composers to have.
Fantastic. He is Michael Barron, Artistic Director for Lyric Theater. Again, it starts off with Oklahoma, June 23rd through the 27th. Tickets, lyrictheaterokc.com. You can also call 524-9312. Michael, always great to catch up. We appreciate
it. Hey, thanks very much.